Hello, this is Nathaniel Rigo. Today we'll be discussing the two-part episode of Power Rangers Turbo, in which the Turbo Rangers meet their maker, at least until the following season, Power Rangers in Space, which serves as the epic conclusion to the Zordon era saga, ranging from Mighty Morphin to Space. In this two-part season finale of the long-running iconic series, Turbo's main villain, Divatox, and her space pirate crew hire an outside source monster known as Gold Goyle to end the Rangers for good. After an intense Megazord fight with the almost unbeatable Giant Fiend, the Rangers retreat to the power chamber where they vow to Demetria, their mentor, and ironically Divatox's twin sister, to remain on Earth to protect it while she and the Blue Centurion, a police android ranger from the future, set out to save Zordon following the fall of his homeworld, Altar. Meanwhile, Divatox and her forces, having found out about the whereabouts of the Rangers in the power chamber, launch a surprise assault on the base, resulting in an all-out war between the Rangers and Divatox's armies of piranhas. The battle ends with the destruction of the base, and the Rangers ending the season finale by setting out to save Zordon, powers or not, except for their child Blue Ranger, Justin, who's to remain on Earth because he's moving from Angel Grove with his father. Now we are to talk about how this season finale in particular cheated me from the start. Between the final battle at the power chamber and the four Rangers and Alpha's escape into space to stop Divatox from destroying mankind and save Zordon along with it. For starters, the first episode of the two-part finale begins with Justin being informed by his father that he's to move away with him, since it means he has to be at a new job out of town. Meanwhile, on the moon, Hoda Divatox's space base after her subcraft originally in the waters of Angel Grove Lake. Since the season had begun, she, her minions, Rygar Porto, and Elgar recruit the giant monster Gold Goyle to destroy the Rangers along with their Megazords. Gold Goyle is a minor far cry from the monsters Divatox has made hired over the course of the season, but as an outside source, he's capable of easily crippling and destroying the Turbo Rescue Megazords in battle. For example, after the Rangers receive an urgent message from Zordon, who tries to warn them of an attack, in which case Gold Goyle engages a giant monster in the Rescue Megazord and uses his powerful blast to destroy their laser cannons without even breaking a sweat. To make matters worse for the Rangers, Gold Goyle greatly damages the Megazord, forcing him to self-destruct it. As they tighten their grip around the vile deviant in an attempt to take him out immediately, somehow Gold Goyle survives this and destroys the Turbo Megazord quite as easily as he has with the Rescue Megazord. One of the first things that this two-part season finale has cheated me is that following both Megazord demises, DJ the Red Turbo Ranger launches a grenade from his vehicle lightning cruiser while airborne into the monster's mouth. It then automatically explodes inside the villain, taking him out instantly. That's the most ridiculous way to end a monster, especially a giant one, because of one of the three rules that the Rangers have to abide by since the first Power Rangers episode Day at the Dumpster in Power Rangers Mighty Morphin. And that's, you should never escalate a fight unless a villain like Rita Repulsa or even Divatox forces you. This rule is defined when TJ feeds Gorgoyle a bomb, despite that he has destroyed both Rangers' Megazords. After the intense Megazord battle, the Rangers regroup at the power chamber while Elgar, Rygarg, and a few piranhas notice them teleporting there in five colored streaks of light and follow them. So they then inform Divatox, and she unifies her armies of piranhas to end the Rangers for good. Another way that this season finale has cheated me is that as they prepare to attack the power chamber with the Rangers inside, Demetria, Blue Centurion, set off to save Zordon, leaving the Rangers to defend their homeworld. Big mistake, because not only have they all less noticed the presence of Divatox and her army, but also the alarms of the power chambers did not alert the Rangers, Alpha, and or other two heroes right away. By the time Blue Centurion and Demetria set out to rescue and aid Zordon, and the Rangers with Alpha realize what's going on outside, it's too late. As a result, The villain's armies raid the power chamber, prompting the Rangers to go outside and engage them, regardless that there are excessively too many of them. The episode ends with the Rangers foolishly running outside to try and negate the threat once and for all. If you think this episode has been bad, part two of the season finale is way worse. The episode begins with the Rangers battling the excessive amount of piranhas, overwhelming them. Their core allies, Blue Thunder and Lightning Cruiser, race in as minor reinforcements. Divatok, noticing this, unquote, "Oh, they brought in the cars. How pathetic." Based on this quote, it's because the piranhas have then easily been able to net and detain the cars without any issues. It forces the Rangers to retreat back into the base as the villains resume their relentless assault upon them. The darkest part of the episode is that Elgar attaches a variety of bombs in the base as the Rangers resume, ending up overwhelmed by the outnumbering squadrons of piranhas. At this point, Divatok bombs the power chamber and the team inside via a remote detonator. What an immoral and unethically cold-hearted thing she has done. There's no honor in destroying an enemy base with a main rival inside. Amid the assault, Divatok and her forces scour the ruins in search of the Rangers to make sure they've been destroyed. But they're interrupted by a human-faced fireball known as the Messenger, who informs Divatok that the great monarch of evil, Dark Spectre, the space version of Malagor, the secondary villain of Power Rangers Turbo, the movie, the film prequel to the whole season, has captured Zordon and demands she and her forces travel to the Sumerian planet in honor of such a slight victory, as the Messenger is less fruitful as Dark Spectre. Regarding their forms of CG, he does insist that Divatok leave for the planet to join the other villains, Rear Lord Zedd and the Amishin Empire, to celebrate Zordon's capture before she enacts humanity's final destruction. After they leave, the surviving Rangers and Alpha emerge from the ruins they've been priorly hiding in, having lost their powers as a result of the base's destruction. Despite all this, the Rangers sneak into a base shuttle prone for space, and at the last minute, they learn of Justin moving away with his father, so he's to remain on Earth for this to work. Alpha and the other four Rangers launch into deep space to save Zordon and prevent Divatok from destroying the human race. One more thing that has me cheated by this two-part season finale is that somehow the Rangers couldn't have survived the explosion. They all could have been vaporized instantly along with Alpha. Even though they have lost their powers and are forced to hijack it away on a space shuttle, taking them right out of orbit. Thanks for stopping by.
Until I, Divatok, run them